Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Snakemake series. Marcos here. In this video, I will introduce the concept of wildcards and how we can use them to make more robust pipelines. So let's get started. We will start with the usual rule copyab, which makes a copy of the file A and renames it file B. When we launch the pipeline, the rule copyab gets run and file B gets generated. Now let's create a second rule, copyac, that makes a copy of the file A and names it file C. We launch the pipeline and the only file that is generated is file B because it's the only one requested in the first rule. So we need to put rule all on top and request both files B and C. If you are not sure how this works, check the rule all videos from this series. Okay, now we launch the pipeline. All rules are run and we get both the B and C files. So far so good, but looking closer at these rules, they are essentially the same. The only difference is the name of the output file. To avoid repetition, we can use wildcards to specify the variable part of the rule and have a more generic rule. To do this, we write the variable part of the output between these curly brackets. And we will also change the name of the rule to copyA instead of copyAB to make it more generic. When we run the pipeline, all rules are run. File B and C are created. And we can see that the variable part of the output has been assigned a wildcard. When the first copy A rule is run, the wildcard X is assigned the value B, and the second time the copy A rule is run, it's the wildcard X is assigned the value C. Snakemake allows us to have a graphic visualization of the pipeline if we run the following command. We can create a PDF with this information. In this case, we see the rule copy A is run twice, using in one case B to specify the wildcard X, and in the other case C is used. We can also see that both rules are run to satisfy the files requires in rule all. Now let's try to run two rules, one that makes a copy of A and names it B, another that makes a copy of A or file B and names it C. We can specify the output of the first rule with a wildcard. When we run the pipeline, Snakemake figures out that it needs to replace the wildcard with B, and all rules are run and both files B and C are generated. However, things can get tricky quite fast. For example, let's assign the output of the second rule with a wildcard. When we launch the pipeline, we get an error message claiming that there is some ambiguity. And this is because file C could be made by the first and the second rule, and Snakemake will not make a decision on this. One way to deal with this is putting some restrictions on the wildcard, which is done using pattern matching. In this case, for example, we are writing that the pattern cannot match a C. So now, when we launch the pipeline, all rules are run and both B and C files are generated and there's no more ambiguity. As you can imagine, we are just scratching the surface of wildcards implementations. So we will stop here, but if you want to learn how wildcards propagates within rules to the inputs and the shells command, click the video on the top left. If you want to explore more concepts of Snakemake, check the Snakemake playlist on the bottom right. I will see you in the next video, and don't forget to subscribe.